Hi guys, James at Rampant Lion Reviews again for you today with another beer review. For this one, we are going to head over to America once again, to the state of California and the city of San Diego, which is very, very well regarded when it comes to its craft beer. And it's one of the kind of well-known breweries that we're going to revisit today. So for this one, we are going to go to Ballast Point Brewing Company once again, and we're having a taste of the Mocha Marlin, which comes in at 6% ABV. So this one's a porter with coffee and chocolate added to it, and apparently it's one of their winter seasonals. And I just happened to come across this one in Seastembo Lagert, so it was a little bit of a surprise, but it's a very highly regarded beer from what I understand. On Rate Beer, it has a 96 overall and a 99 within the style. So, you know, Rate Beer, as I always say, take it with a bit of a pinch of salt, but, you know, it usually does give you a fairly good barometer of how good your beer is going to be. So very much looking forward to trying this one, and as always, I hope you guys enjoy my take on this beer. So anyway, as is usual with my reviews, then I'll tell you a little bit about the brewery. If you want to get straight to the tasting, just fast forward. All the usual links are in the description below. That's the brewery website, the link to my other reviews that I've done from Ballast Point before. No doubt there will be some more in the near future because the beers are fairly widely available here in Sweden. There's all the usual social media. If you want to see more beer reviews, do please consider subscribing to the channel. The whole channel, of course, has a geography-based tagging system, so you can go into the homepage and search for beer based on country, city, state, county, prefecture, whatever it is you're interested in. Do check out the playlist of beers from different countries. There is one there for all the American beers that I've reviewed for you. That's constantly being added to. And as always, please do get in touch and let me know some of the other beers and breweries that you guys would like to see me review. It's always great to hear from you guys that are watching the videos, and the support that you show the channel is hugely appreciated. So anyway, to tell you a little bit about the brewery itself then. So Ballast Point Brewing Company, as I mentioned to you, are based in San Diego in California, and they were founded by a group of friends back in 1996. So Jack White and his roommate Peter Hearn had homebrewed together during their time at UCLA, and after university, Jack opened the Homebrew Mart in San Diego, and apparently many of his customers have gone on to found their own breweries now. And this is, you know, as I say, San Diego is really widely regarded as one of the craft beer cities over in America. But Peter Hearn went off to UC Davis to train for his Master Brewer certificate, and he was the head brewer of Ballast Point, the original head brewer. However, he decided to take a back seat soon after, and the company hired Yusuf Cherney, and they established a backroom brewery at the Homebrew Mart in 1996, which marked the birth of the Ballast Point Brewing Company. But the name apparently comes from a historically important site at Point Loma in San Diego too. But in 2004, the brewery opened a large facility at Scripps Ranch, and in 2013 they opened a new brewery, tasting room and restaurant in Little Italy, which also functions as their beer lab, which I think this is a slightly smaller brewery that they have there. But by 2014 they'd outgrown their brewery at Scripps Ranch, and so they began the construction of a new facility in Miramar, which opened in 2014, and this also contained a tasting room and restaurant as well. Since 2008 they've also produced spirits, and the Scripps Ranch facility serves as their current distillery. But Jack White acted as president and CEO until June of 2015, when the role was taken over by Jim Buechner, who had been general manager since 2012, and Cherney is still the head brewer and the operations manager too. But the company then filed for was offered as public stock in October of 2015, and in December of 2015 the company was taken over by Constellation Brands, who were based over in New York. But by July 2016, the four of the original founders, which included White, Cherney and Buechler, had left over a dispute regarding the distillation part of the business, which apparently wasn't included in the original deal. So Ballast Point Brewing Company, if you like, is not run by the original people. It's run by Constellation Brands completely, and a new team that are involved there. And the original distillery part of the business, I think these guys actually do have their own distillery now, and they're operating that. I forget what the name of it is, but yeah, Ballast Point Brewing Company is now fully in the hands of Constellation Brands. So this was one of the big controversies at the time. These guys, Ballast Point, were one of the breweries that were one of the first breweries to get involved with the big companies, and it was a little bit of a controversy at the time. But that said, Constellation Brands do seem to have kept up the quality of the beer. Some people might debate that, but my experience of the beers that I've had here in Sweden, the quality does seem to be roughly the same. So yeah, you know, I don't really want to get too much into the whole corporate versus craft kind of thing. I just want to actually have a taste of this beer. But the beers I've had from Ballast Point before have always been pretty good, and I'm very curious to see what this one holds. So yeah, if you want to learn a little bit more about the brewery, check out the brewery website in the description below, and you can follow them on Facebook and Instagram and things like that, and keep up to date with all the latest goings on. But let's get on and have a taste of this beer then. So as I mentioned to you at the start of the video, this one is a 6% porter and it's got coffee and chocolate added to it. But yeah, there you can see, there's the marlin on this one, you know, the swordfish, if you want to give it its kind of more common name. But really nice to present. All the Ballast Point beers, of course, there is a kind of fishing theme, angling theme to this brewery there. You can see that on the top of the label there as well, which is quite nice. And you can see that is also on the bottle cap too. So this one, I think this might be a 355 milliliter bottle. I think this is one of these American measurements where it's so many fluid ounces. The Americans, of course, as I always complain, do not use normal people measurements. They've got their own system, which is you know, which is a look quite a bit different from European measurements, half litres and 330s and things like that that we like to use here. But let's get this beer out and we'll get on with the tasting then. As I say, very curious to try this one, particularly considering how highly regarded it is on Rate Beer. So yeah, so as you can see with this beer, and as you would expect with it being a porter, you can see it's poured a lovely dark ebony rosewood colour. So there's a solid two fingers of a frothy, I would say kind of medium tan head on this one. It looks absolutely lovely. We can get rid of the brewery notes now, but yeah, you can really smell some of these lovely coffee notes popping out of this beer as you open up. But a lovely two finger frothy kind of medium tan head on this one. One or two big bubbles sticking towards the side of the glass and a few little ones just heading up towards the bottom of that head there. But you know, overall it does look pretty nice. I like how everything is going to how this one appears, but nothing overall particularly surprising about this beer in terms of its appearance. But let's have a closer look at the aroma and just see how we get on here. Oh yeah, as soon as you go into this beer, straight away you're going to smell the coffee on this. And to me, as I've always said about coffee stouts and things like that, coffee can add just a real complexity to it, because every coffee bean has its own little characteristics. Some of them are a little bit more earthy, some of them are a bit more roasted, some of them are a bit more aromatic and fruity and stuff like this. To me, the coffee in this one comes across as being very, very smooth. It's got a good little bit of a... It's really got a bit of very smooth earthiness to it as well. There's a little bit of a chocolatey quality coming out of this one as well. It's almost like you've got coffee, like very, very ground up coffee beans in this one. And you've also got a little bit of a... it's almost like hot chocolate powder, actually, it smells like it's been put in this one. It very much smells like, you know, like Nesquik powder or something like that. It really has that kind of aroma to it. It's got a lovely kind of sweet and powdery chocolate quality. If you take it in a bit more deeply in that, it starts to become a little bit more milky in terms of the chocolatey qualities as well. But really, it almost smells like the... If you eat a bowl of Cocoa Pops, it almost smells like the milk after you've eaten all the Cocoa Pops. It really does smell like that, this beer. But you get a little bit more of a kind of roasty coffee quality to this one as well, which is very nice. So yeah, a lovely balance between almost like hot chocolate and coffee in the aroma of this one. Almost like a quite creamy coffee. I actually don't know if mocha is more of a creamy coffee, because I never ever drink coffee. I've never been that into it, but I love these coffee stouts and coffee porters and things like that you're getting these days. I think, you know, to drink coffee would probably be a bad thing for me just now. It would send me on the roof, because I'm just not used to those levels of caffeine. But yeah, the malty kind of side of the aroma, the sweeter side of things in this, is very, very nice. There's almost a little touch of a woody, nutty kind of thing in there as well. If you take the beer in quite deeply, you can get a little bit of that. I want to say there's a little touch of almost brown sugar in there as well, a slightly toasted caramel, but mainly, as I say, coffee and that almost kind of hot chocolatey powder. The aroma of this beer is very, very nice. So on that note, we'll say thumbs up. This is one of the best aromas I've had out of a porter, actually. I would go that far with this beer. But other than that, you can get a little bit of earthiness from the hops. There's a little tiny touch of a red fruit coming out of this one, but the aroma, as you would expect from the porter, is very malt focused. It's quite sweet and quite chocolatey and stuff like that too. So yeah, lovely smelling beer this one. So just take a little bit of time and enjoy the aroma of the beer before you get stuck into it. But we are going to have a taste of this one now. So this is the Mocha Marlin from Ballast Point Brewing Company over in San Diego in California. Lovely, lovely beer this one, so apparently. So let's get stuck in and have a taste of this. It is my first taste of the beer, by the way. Excuse my brain fart that I had there. Yeah. Let me just say straight away with this one. I can see exactly why this beer is so highly rated as a porter. This one's just absolutely lovely. It's really, really well done. It's got it, it's it, you know, the coffee sweetness in this one, it really does lean towards the coffee side of things, and you'd expect that because of the name, to be quite honest with you. And it's a lot, if you like your porters to be roasty and toasty, and you like a coffee, if you like a coffee stout, you really are going to enjoy this one. I like what they've done with this beer. Yeah, so with this beer, you can feel there's a little bit of a roasty black malt backbone to this one. That's what you would expect. On top of that, you can feel the coffee beans just kind of really rolling out the smoothness as you go along here. This beer has a lovely smoothness from the coffee beans. It's quite an earthy coffee that's in this one, I would say. Although at the same time, I think further towards the front of the palate, it's got just a little touch of aromaticity, but you can feel that roasty black malt backbone there, and the coffee just rolls all the way forward on the tongue. You've got a little bit of a slightly sweeter chocolate kind of flavour to this one as well, and I think it's more of a milky chocolate. It's not more of a kind of dark, high cocoa chocolate, I would say. More of a milky chocolate coming out of this beer, I would think. In the middle of your palate, too, I think there's a little bit of a kind of brown, sugary element to this beer. And yeah, if you go to the very centre of your palate, you've got a nice, almost slightly well-fired caramel in there. You've got a lovely, nice brown, sugary note to this beer, which I think comes out very nicely, and it complements the coffee and the chocolatey part of this beer. This is one of these beers where everything just kind of goes together very, very well, and it works so well, this beer. You know, I can see, as I said earlier, I can see exactly why this one is so highly rated. And the further into the aftertaste you go, more of the roasty kind of coffee elements come out, but you start to gradually get a little bit of woodiness out of this beer. There's a little touch of a kind of nutty, there's a little touch of a kind of nutty note coming out of this beer as well, the further into the aftertaste you go, which is really, really nice. In the back corners of the palate, there's a little bit of a there's a little touch of a roasty earthiness to this one. I do wonder if they've used Summit or something in this hop. I always remember Summit being a very popular hop for port for American porters and stuff like that. But in the back corners of the palate, you've got a good bit of quite a strong dark earthiness there. But as you come further forward along the sides of your palate, that just smooths out a little bit. You get a little touch of a kind of floral note towards the front corners of your palate as well. Then round the very front curve of your tongue, it's just a little bit lighter and more grassy there. But that earthiness really spreads quite far forward in this one. It's just a very, very slight grassiness around the front curve of your palate. But yeah, behind the front curve of the tongue, then that's where you get a little bit of these juicy fruity esters, and this beer isn't the most fruity one you're going to come across. There's maybe a teeny, teeny, teeny little bit of a kind of figgy quality to this one. As I say, you just get that little oily bubble behind the front curve of your tongue where these fruity, juicy esters come out. This one has a very slight kind of candied, a kind of, it has a very slight kind of candied strawberry thing to it. The further you go into the aftertaste, on the very tip of your tongue, you just get a very slight kind of candied strawberry note to the beer, but mainly it's a very light kind of juicy figgy quality there. But this beer, it's one of these ones that it's actually quite simple in its flavours. I don't find this beer to be overly complex, but what it aims to do, it actually does it very, very well. You know, it's got a lovely black malt base. The way the coffee flavours come out is really nice, and the way the chocolate kind of integrates that into that and just smooths it out a little bit is also very, very nice. I really like how this beer goes together. I can see why in the porter category it's very highly rated. If you like your porters to be a bit more roasty and toasty, this one's going to be for you. If you like your coffee stouts but want something with a bit of a lighter mouthfeel, again, this is one I think you're going to really quite enjoy. So if this is you know, if it sounds like it's going to tick the boxes for you, I'm pretty sure that it will. It's a very, very solid beer. This one doesn't try to be overly complex, but just does everything pretty damn well, I have to say. In terms of the mouthfeel, then, this beer for me, bottom end of mid-bodied. I think it's fair to say that on this one. Yeah. Bottom end of mid-bodied, this beer. Carbonation is very, very smooth. Mouthfeel has a little bit of creaminess to it, I would say, but a little touch of oily quality in there as well. Good little bit of bitterness from the hoppy side of things. I think this beer is maybe somewhere between the 50 and 60 IBU mark. Little bit of, as I say, the malt base leans towards the roasty side of things, but the coffee really helps smooth it out a little bit, and you have got a little bit of an almost creamy effect to this beer as well, which I think is coming from the chocolate, and you've got a tiny little bit of a juicy fruity quality in there as well. I would say 60 IBU is a little bit coming from the malt base and a little bit from the hops as well, but a lovely, lovely beer this one, and one that I certainly wouldn't hesitate to drink again. It really is a very, very good winter beer, this one. So yeah, let's leave it at that for this. I think very, very solid beer, and I think if you guys try this one for yourself, if you're a fan of the style or coffee stouts, you're very much going to enjoy this beer. So yeah, once again, thank you for watching my beer reviews. Until the next time, please like, subscribe, share, all the usual YouTube stuff. Let me know your own thoughts on this beer in the comment section below. Let me know what your favourite beers are from Ballast Point as well. And I'm looking forward to reviewing more beers from these guys in the future. This one was the Mocha Marlin, a porter at 6% with coffee and chocolate added to it. One of the winter releases from Ballast Point over in San Diego, over in America. Just a lovely beer. Doesn't try to be too complex, but very, very solid within the style. Until the next time, it's Slanja just now, and I will catch you guys later. Slanja, skål, cheers.